Hello everyone, welcome to Saola Animate Tutorials. This is a quick start guide that gets you started with Saola. Before we get started, let's see what we can create with the application first. A gift bar gradually appears on screen. I'll click it.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
And you can see when it clicks the box disappears. A bunch of balloons flies in and a happy birthday song plays. So it can be an amazing gift to a friend on his birthday. And now I walk you through the steps to create these interactive animations. The first step is to prepare the content of a document. You need to have two images and an audio. Now I create a new project. You can customize the size of a document. Enter a new size here or use preset sizes. In this project, I will use the default. Click the Fit All Screen button to set the scene contents fit to the viewport size. In the Properties pane, notice Overflow property. Set a value to Hidden so that any content beyond the scene will be hidden. The next step is to import content into the Resources pane. If you don't see this pane on the main menu, choose the View menu and select Resources. In the Resources pane, click Import button and import all resources. Now I create animations for each of the three resources. The gift box is the first. In the first 2 seconds, the gift box gradually appears on screen. Then it scales up a bit and quickly backs to its original size. Drag the box onto the canvas. Position it in the center of the scene. Notice the two red lights here. They help you align elements on the canvas. Add keyframes for the opacity property. Set the value to 0%. On the timeline, position the playhead to the second second. Add another keyframe for a scene property. Set the value to 100%. Now add two keyframes for the width and height properties. Move the playhead to 2.5 seconds. Add two other keyframes for scene properties, then enter a new width. The height of the element will change accordingly as they are linked together. Now move the playhead to the 3rd second and make the element back to its original size. Move on to the balloons. Draw the balloons onto the canvas and position it outside the scene. When you click a gift, the balloons fly in from the bottom, so I animate the top property. Add a keyframe for a top property. Then move the playhead to the 8th second. Add another keyframe and draw the element to the center of the scene. You can see an animation segment appearing on the timeline. To smooth the transition and make it more natural, I'll add a custom easing method to it. Select an animation segment. Click the easing button. Choose any easing method you like. Here I choose out elastic. The last element is the audio. Drag the audio resource onto the canvas. You can see the player controls here. I'll hide it by uncheck the controls attribute in the properties pane. Don't worry about the playback as I'll handle it later with event and actions. Now I'll add interactivity to make the content interactive. Position the playhead to the 3rd second. In the timeline pane, click the Insert Trigger button. Click Add Action, select Timeline, pause Timeline. This way, the timeline will pause at the 3rd second. For the event and actions, I'll add 2 events. The first one is a mouse click on the gift box element. In the timeline pane, click the Open Element Actions button of the gift box element. Select mouse click as an event. Click Add Action and Add 2 actions. First is to hide the gift box. Then continue the timeline you've just paused. And play the song with media. Start media action. The second event is a mouse click on the balloons. Chances are you want to pause the song for a while, so So I'll automatically event registered with the media, toggle play or pause mediation. Let's preview to view the whole project. Click the preview button on the toolbar. The gift bar appears on screen. Click it.
Happy birthday to you.
To export the project to HTML5, on the toolbar, click the export to HTML5 button. You can choose to open either the HTML file or the containing folder. So I've shown you some common steps to create interactive animations in Saola Animate. Thank you for watching.